Hello friends, in this video let us see the differential pressure or head principle in flow rate measurement. Okay, so when we usually want to measure the flow rate of any fluid flowing in a pipe, so we have to use obstruction type of instruments which will be using the drop in the head or the drop in the pressure as a way of measuring the flow rate. So now let us consider here a pipe with a cross section A, and there is a fluid flowing in this particular pipe at a density of rho, and it is moving with a velocity of v. Okay, so it is continuously moving in the pipe all the time, and when we want to measure the flow rate of this, so as per the formula it is nothing but flow rate equal to velocity into cross sectional area. Okay, so now it is also true that at any two places in the pipe, if flow rate is measured, it is going to remain same. So this basic principle can be exploited further to obtain the flow rate. So now let us consider a obstruction in between the pipe, which is nothing but this orifice plate. Now this orifice plate will have a very small opening in the center, so which will be allowing the fluid to flow through it, and rest of the area will be blocking the flow of the fluid. So now the fluid is again flowing from this end and it is coming up to the plate. Now it sees the obstruction and the flow will it will reduce its velocity at this side of the plate, and with the small opening other side, with a very high velocity the fluid will start coming out. Okay, so here you can imagine that there is a very high velocity compared to this side, and further the fluid is continuously coming at this side of the plate and it is getting accumulated with a very low velocity, hence it is causing very high pressure on these walls. Therefore let us say the velocity at this side is V1 and at the same time the pressure is P1. The pressure here is higher and velocity here is lower. Now on the other side of this orifice plate, here as the content of the fluid is smaller at this particular nearer area of the orifice plate, so therefore because of that the pressure is lower. So let us say that pressure is P2, and at the same time the velocity is very very high, which is V2. So now also we have to observe that this particular opening is having a cross sectional area of just A2. Okay, so therefore now here pressure is P2 and this side the pressure is P1, which is higher compared to P2. Therefore when we are using a pressure tube, so which is containing a fluid, so the fluid will be equal when the pipe is connected to the pipe like this, which is not having any obstruction. So here also and here also the pressure will remain exactly same, but in this case the pressure is different. Therefore the fluid will start moving from one side and it will come to the other side up to a particular level where the other side pressure is stopping it. So that is equilibrium situation. So therefore here the pressure is P2 and here the pressure is P1. So this level is measured and this level is nothing but the loss in the head, which is indicated by H. H is given by P1 minus P2 divided by rho. So therefore this will give us the differential head or differential pressure. Now this can be used to measure the flow rate, as velocity is equal to V into K1 into root of H. So here K1 is nothing but the restriction constant. As we know that here there is A1 which is cross-sectional area of the pipe, and there is A2 which is the cross-sectional area of the orifice plate. So this cross-sectional area is smaller and this cross-sectional area is larger. So if we take the ratio of the two, so we'll get the restriction constant. A1 by A2 gives us K1, which is the restriction constant for the flow of fluid in the pipe. So therefore the flow rate is nothing but area times velocity. So substituting velocity as k1 into h in the above formula, we get flow rate is equal to ak1h, which therefore we get flow rate is directly proportional to h, which is nothing but flow rate is directly proportional to the differential pressure.